started this morning. Welcome to Shining Light Baptist Church. We are almost at a close to this first month of the year. Amen. It's good to be in the Lord's house, and I'm excited about what God is doing in our midst. We do have our first hymn we're going to be singing this morning, but I don't know if you received the reply of the text message Brother Anna Ray had there up there in the Pine Top Lakeside area. Got 2 to 3 inches of snow today. Up in that area, and he sent those pictures, and I just asked him when they come to visit, please do not bring the snow with him in my area, amen. You are free to receive it in yours, amen, but I don't want any snow anytime soon, amen. All right, well, we are here. Welcome to those that are online viewing. Welcome to those that are here, and we know still there are some that cannot make it, don't feel as comfortable yet, and we respect that, and just trust God's going to work everything out as 2021 unfolds itself, and looking forward to seeing what God's going to do. New name in glory is our song, amen. I was once a sinner, but I came pardon received from my Lord. So let's sing that out this morning as you reminisce on your salvation and how and when God saved you and from what he saved you. Mr. G2. Just a little bit as we get to stay more under wraps, but God knows what's going on. He's in control, and he's in charge. And so let's go to the Lord in prayer, trusting him to work in our midst today. Father, we thank you for being a God that provides everything that we need. Thank you for every aspect of what you have done for us, Lord, in just the opening weeks of 2021, how you provided. Thank you for transition of power for our new president. And the Lord, we do pray for President Biden and Vice President Harris, Lord, as you work in their administration. And Lord, deal with them the same way you dealt with Trump. Guide them, place those counselors in their pathway, or those that will speak the word of God to them, and give them the encouragement from Scripture that, Lord, our nation could not stumble and fall more than it already has, or we might see a healing spiritually. We know that's not going to really happen until the gospel message gets to hearts, people get born again, and surrender to Almighty God. Also, I do pray that our freedoms would still continue to stand, the Bible would be able to be preached, and what we'd be able to witness and give the gospel. And Lord, start with the White House, going to the House of Representatives, the Senate, Congress, all of those in leadership, not just in our nation's capital, but in our state and in our city and in our town. Well, we know most of that starts with us. And our prayers, so that my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray. Lord, help us be a praying people, praying for our nation, praying for our families, praying for ourselves, that Lord, you might use us as we put you first in this 2021st year. Thank you for loving us, Lord. Minister to those viewing online. Help them to pay attention on purpose, not be distracted by things of the home. And help us as well, Lord, to give our full attention here in this auditorium to the word and the preaching of the word of God, and then the singing of the songs of Zion. Thank you. Love you, Lord. Comfort those that are suffering from COVID. Heal those that are down with the illnesses. And Lord, we just pray that when it's all said and done, you'll give us the continued victory in Christ. And we'll thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. Well, praise the Lord. If you have not already received your stewardship statement for 2020, it will be to you probably in the next week. Pastor White's going to get those out to you. And as always, if there's a discrepancy on what you thought you gave as opposed to what we put down, please get with Pastor White so we can get that rectified and get you a corrected statement out to you. If you're viewing online, you should get yours within the next couple of weeks. And so I know tax season is here and everybody wants to go ahead and file their taxes and get the contributions on your file. And I know some say, well, I don't need that, amen. But if you need it, it's going to be available for you to utilize, amen. It's a good tool to use to show what's been given. You get deducted on your taxes, get some money back, and you can give more, amen. Praise God. That's just how that works. Praise the Lord. God is good. God is great, amen. All right, we've got another song we're going to sing this morning. He's so great, I'm so small. And I want you to think about this as well. Think about the greatness of God in 2020. What did God do for you that showed himself great? Amen. There's a COVID that came upon us all, and God was greatly showing himself day after day, week after week, month after month. He's still doing that right now. So we're going to sing this song, He's So Great, I'm So Small. Amen. Only a children's song, but it's still a good, good song. Amen. All right, first stanza.
He's so great and I'm so small. Jesus, hold me, bless my mom. He's the ruler over all. He's so great and I'm so small. He's the shepherd, I'm the sheep. He's the shepherd.
He is my God and I'm secure. Jesus. stanza as to what God has done in your life, amen, but God is really working some marvelous things in our midst, and I tell you what, looking forward to seeing what God is going to do in 2020, amen. Well, we're going to start in Hebrews 13 this morning. My sister Dawson is going to be singing here in just a minute. Hebrews 13, and we're going to read verses 5 and 6. Hebrews 13, 5 and 6, and so you can get that area earmarked in your Bibles. Say, preacher, what is there? You will see. Amen. Hebrews 13, verses 5 and 6. And so Mrs. Dawson is going to come up and sing for us, and then we'll get right into our message for today.
Oh,
our help truly does come from the Lord. Amen. And we're going to see a little bit of that today in the passage. Amen. So thank you again, Mr. Dawson, for reminding us of that message. All of our help comes from the Lord. Amen. Maybe we can get that screen up. Amen. Thank you. I've only got like 2 weeks left today and next week with my lights, and I love my lights. Amen. How many of y'all like lights? I love lights. Amen. I really do. All right, Hebrews 13, and we're going to be reading verses 5 and 6. And so go ahead and stand if you're able as we read those two. If you're following along at home online with us, Hebrews 13, and verses 5 and 6, for some of us that might ring a bell. Amen. Hebrews 13, verses 5 and 6. And so we're going to read those two verses. By the way, since August, we've been preaching on investing more in that which cannot be taken away, like a relationship with God and His Word, His Holy Spirit, and prayer. And now we're returning to our theme from 2020, as you see behind me. The Lord is, and the Lord is my. Amen. In this area here, the Lord is my helper. Amen. Hebrews 13, verses 5 and 6. Let's go ahead and read those verses together, if you're able. Here we go. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as you have. For he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. So that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Amen. Notice that we may boldly say, Lord is my helper. You know, if we're here today, I think we can boldly say, the Lord helped us in 2020. Amen. I believe we can confidently say that. Amen. We're here. And so God enabled us to get through 2020, through the pandemic. Yeah, we might have some bumps and bruises and some scrapes and scratches, amen. And guess what? We made it through, amen. I don't know about you, but I lost some weight through the pandemic, amen. My doctor told me my sugar was too high, too much candy, amen. I had to cut candy out and lost 13 pounds just from cutting out sweets, amen. Now, once I got out of the clear, I picked up a few sweets, amen. And then I went home to visit my family on Christmas, and they gave me sweets, amen. Then I had an anniversary, and I got more sweets. And so I think I padded on about 10 pounds of that, 13, amen. But anyway, amen, God got us through 2020, and he has been our helper. And so we're going to look at some things today as we kind of go back down memory lane and reflect on some things and see what God has done as our helper in 2020 and what he wants to do in 2021. He wants to do some great things, amen? Father, thank you once again for sustaining us, being our helper. Thank you for not leaving us and not forsaking us, Lord, and so we can boldly say with much confidence that you are the Lord, our helper. Lord, speak through me this morning of the words of God that need to be spoken to bring encouragement, to bring faith, to bring confidence. Lord, to bring that which we cannot see into view with a God who knows and sees it all. Lord, we need your strength today. Lord, preach through me the wonderful works of God. Lord, open our ears, open our hearts so that we receive and leave here encouraged, Lord, more so than when we came in. And Lord, may we leave differently than when we came in as well, more knowledgeable about your power, more knowledgeable about your might, and the more, Lord, reassured that you have 2021 covered just like you had it in 2020. We thank you, Lord. I pray for anyone here today without the Lord Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, that man, woman, boy, or girl would receive Christ before it's everlasting too late. Lord, understanding the need of a Savior. We have all sinned and come short of the glory of God, and the wages of those same sins is death. But Lord, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. And help that man, woman, boy, or girl to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be saved today. We thank you for loving us. Lord, minister to those online, viewing on the World Wide Web, and then those of us that are here in the congregation. Open our hearts as well. And we'll thank you for it all in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. You may be seated. Well, we restarted in August after being gone since March. Because of the COVID caution. And we left off with the particular subject, a title called The Lord is My Helper. Now, it's not one of the ones that's listed up there because we only had a certain amount of room. But we did leave off on The Lord is My Helper. This particular passage here in Hebrews is written at the close of chapter 13, and it's at the end of the book of Hebrews, and much is discussed in chapters 1 through 12, and the Hebrews were in fear of their lives, and so a lot of things were going on with this book. There was some fence straddling going on, there were some believers there, some persecution, a lot of things were happening. Here towards the end, the encouragement is given so that we may boldly say, verse 6, the Lord is my helper. And I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Reading through the book, you find out that a lot of men were doing a lot of things to the Hebrews, amen? Just historically, we know that Hitler had a thing for the Jews, and many, many others had a thing for the Jews. It seemed like they were always being persecuted. But let me tell you something, God's people have always been persecuted. I mean, you go back into the beginning, Joseph was persecuted by his own brothers, amen? Everybody that you find that stood for God had some man against them. The book of Hebrews, though, is trying to get us not to fear. This actual quote comes from Psalm 118. So let's go back there as we revisit a few things here. Psalm 118, and notice verse number 6, there's a lot that could make the Hebrews fearful in their Christian life. But notice the quote in Hebrews is taken from Psalm 118 and verse number 6. And notice how verse number 6 reads. And if you're there, read it with me. The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do unto me? Question mark. You know, the worst they can do is send us to heaven. Think about it. The worst anybody can do is kill you. That is the utmost that someone can do, is to kill you. Amen. But guess what? As soon as you close your eyes here, you open them up in glory.
Amen.
That's a good change of scenery. Amen. That's a good change. Question mark, what can man do unto me? If the Lord is on my side, I will not fear. Amen. I used to play basketball. I used to always like to get the tall people on my side, like Brother Hall. Amen. And then I would look at the other team. Ha ha, y'all don't have anybody to talk. We're going to mop you up. Amen. What was I saying? I'm not going to fear you. Why? I've got tall people on my side. Amen. And they will block your shots. Amen. I never heard someone say, ha ha, we got short people on our side. We're not going to fear. No, they were the most fearing ones, amen. We don't fear, we don't lose, amen. So the tall folks and the big folks, and they were like, hey, I got tall people on my side. I'm not going to fear. You can't beat us. What, a team of midgets? That's not doing a whole lot, amen. The psalmist says, if the Lord is on my side, I will not fear. What can man do unto me? Amen. I go back to Hebrews 13 and verse number 6. So that is where the quote is taken from in Hebrews 13, 6, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. They're saying, hey, God is on our side. We're going to boldly say, the Lord is my helper. I don't have to fear what man should do unto me, because a lot of men are doing a lot of things to me, to us as a nation, to us as Hebrews, to us as Christians. I don't have to fear. By the way, what made the Hebrews so fearful, and why did they need the encouragement? And that's what the book of Hebrews goes on to answer. And those are questions answered throughout the text coming up to this point in 13, which leads them to the confident statement to say, the Lord is my helper. He's going to be there, and he's going to help me. By the way, the same encouragement that helped them helps us through a pandemic. Amen. Lord is on my side. What can man do? Not give me a stimulus check? God's got a better stimulus package than man. No, I'm not going to turn it down and give you one. But God has the ability to do a whole lot more than that. Last year, I was preaching about personally finding out what our Lord could be to us and what our Lord is to us on a daily basis from the theme, the Lord is good, long-suffering, with you, merciful, other things. And the Lord is my shepherd, song, light. deliverer, began looking at many of those titles. We only got through a few before we had COVID, amen. But just think with me just for a moment. What did you need the Lord to be for you or your family in 2020? Financial provider, maybe. Jobs for loss. Maybe an occupational provider. Maybe a healer for a family member, a loved one. Just think about it for a second. What do you need in pain? For some, they need sanity because they have the children at home. And they weren't used to that. And so they needed God to come in there and organize their day with their children because this was new for them. They weren't used to having children in the house. They weren't used to having noise in the house. My wife and I didn't have our children last weekend because the whites had our children, and then it was quiet. It was quiet, almost too quiet. No, it wasn't too quiet. Yeah. And then the kids came back home, they're like, ah, that's what it feels like, yes. Daddy, I need. Mommy, I want. Me. I thought, we missed that. We missed that. No, we didn't miss it that much, amen. But it was different, amen. What did you need the Lord to be? And will you need him to be the same thing in 2021? Guess what? We really don't know. We really don't know. The things that you needed last year, you might not need this year. You may need something different. And God still can be your helper. Why? He knows what you need, amen? He knows what is going to happen. We don't know what we will need tomorrow. We don't know what we're going to need this week. We don't know what we're going to need this month. We don't know what we're going to need this year. We had the Missions Conference Sunday with Alfred King on the 8th. And the 15th, we were supposed to come Sunday morning, and guess what? We didn't show up on Sunday morning. We didn't know that week was going to call for that. We didn't know that the next several weeks and months would call for that. And 5 months later, we finally came back. Did I know that was going to happen? I did not. I did not. Did I prepare for that last year? I did not. Did you? Did you go out and stock up on Lysol and toilet paper before the pandemic? I didn't. Did you go out and get all the Clorox bleach and all those? I didn't. And guess what? I found myself without. I had to rely upon the Lord, my helper. So when you look at this, we really don't know. We do know we have a new president. We do know we got a new vice president. We do know that there are going to be new laws. We do know that they will be more liberal than the Republican Party. And be it as it may, is that going to stop the Lord from being our helper? No. That's still going to be a helper. We haven't had presidents and vice presidents before. And guess what God still was? Our helper. So don't look at a regime or an administration and say, oh, they're going to bring change or they're going to help America or they're going to bring ruin to America. Now, they might bring both of those. But guess what? God's still going to be our helper. And God's still going to take us through. Hey, the book of Hebrews was written to the Jews at a time when they needed encouragement the most. You and I are in a situation where we need help the most. Coming off of a pandemic, we're still in it, amen. People are still dying. Arizona is off the charts. Our children are having to play sports, wrestling, and basketball, and all these other things with masks on now. That is just unheard of. It's crazy. But this is what's happening, amen. We really don't know what we will need in 2021, but we do know that God will be whatever we need him to be for every day and all situations. That's why he was last year. I am the Lord, I change not, he said over Malachi. And so we know he will be. Before that pandemic, we covered the Lord is my shepherd, which you see up here. Then we saw the Lord is good. By the way, the Lord is good. Amen. That was followed by the Lord is my light and my salvation and my strength. Then we began saying the Lord is my helper, as you see here in Hebrews 13:6. Notice again. So that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. But why are we saying that? Verse number 5. Let your conversation or your manner of life be without covetousness. Don't desire what you don't have. and be content with such things as you have. Why? For he has said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee, so that we may boldly say, what? The Lord is my helper. So the Hebrews are saying, you know what? I don't have to worry about anything because God's going to help me through whatever I need. Amen and amen. We need that for 2021. Amen. There may come a time when we may find ourselves just like we did in the early months of last year. Not finding toilet paper, not finding this or that or the other, whatever the situation may be. People are still dying. And so, by the way, if we made it through 2020, the Lord was our helper. He was our shepherd. He was good to us. He was our light. He was our salvation. He was our strength. And more, if he did it then, guess what he can do now? The same thing. Same thing. So what I want to do over the next couple of weeks here as we look at the Lord is my helper is to take us back and kind of see what we saw in the Lord is my shepherd. What did we see in the Lord is good? Just give us a snippet of some of the things that were there, because I believe since it's been almost a year, we need to be refreshed to find out what God has done for us already, what he wants to continue to do, because there's a lot of these that we just didn't get a chance to go through because we got stopped in March. And we only had January and February. And that was not a whole lot. But let's go back just a minute for a review and for a reminder. Go to Psalm 23. Psalm 23, because the first one that we saw was the Lord is my shepherd. Psalm 23. Of course, this is one of the famous Psalms of David, Psalm 23. If you were like me, you learned that as a child, and you had to quote that as a child, and it has stayed with you from a child, amen. And if you didn't know anything else, you knew the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Amen. If you didn't know anything else, you knew that much. Psalm 23. And in Psalm 23, this was one of our first in the series of messages. We began looking at the first four words in Psalm 23. The first four words, read them with me. The Lord is my. And we began to look at those, just those four words. The Lord is my. Because David made this psalm very practical and very personal from a shepherd's position, his responsibility to his sheep. David counted himself the sheep. He counted God his shepherd. And so we looked at those words here. Notice the first two of those words, the Lord. And we saw how he's powerful. He's Jehovah. He's self-existent. He's the eternal one. His name means Jehovah. And it means, it carries with the idea, the one who is, the one who was, and who is to be. He's the eternal one. He is everything that you need. He has no beginning. He has no end. You say, but preacher, we have a beginning. We have an end. But he does not. Amen. But Jesus had a beginning. No, Jesus didn't have a beginning. He just stepped out of eternity into time to be born as a child, to grow up, just to be crucified for our sins, to go right back to what he was doing before, being the eternal one. Amen. God just took on a body in the form of Jesus Christ, amen, to die for our sin. Why? One man sinned, one man had to pay for it, amen. So the Lord is the first two words. What's the third word? The Lord is. The word is means to be. We saw our Lord has potential to be what we need him to be. By the way, God was what you needed him to be in 2020. Right? By the way, not only that, God used others to help you to be what you are. Amen. God is not restricted to just using supernatural power. He can use that supernatural power to direct people. Hey, by the way, he directed the president to give y'all money, didn't he? If you don't want it, you can give it to me. Amen. Hey, he is not restricted to just saying, supernaturally, I'm going to give you something. No. He puts it in the minds of men, women, sometimes young people to help you out. Amen. And so the third word is means to be. God has the potential to be what we need him to be. And beyond, then we saw the fourth word there. The Lord is my. My means personal or belonging to a particular person rather than to anyone else. I have my wife. Guess what? She is mine. She belongs to me. I married her January 14th. 1984. She is mine. She's my wife. She's not the wife. She's not a wife. She's my wife. And guess what? Your wife is your wife. Your husband is your husband. And you can say my husband, my wife. Amen. You can say they're my children. Amen. You could say it's your money, but that would probably be false, and your spouse probably wouldn't agree with that. Amen. And so, the Lord is mine. He became mine February 3rd, 1991, and Jesus Christ became my wife's as well, February 3rd, 1991. My wife became mine January 14th, amen. That's why we celebrate our anniversary. It's not enough to say the Lord is a shepherd, or the Lord is the shepherd. He must be personally my shepherd and your shepherd. If he is not your shepherd, you can't claim his promises, amen. Anything that you get is grace. And then if you don't get his mercy, amen? And so he must be your personal Lord. Another Psalm 23 again. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not what? Want. What did Hebrews say? So when they boldly say, the Lord is my helper, I don't have to fear what man's going to do to me. Why? He's never going to leave me nor forsake me. So I don't have to live my life with a bunch of covetousness. I can have my life without covetousness. Why? The Lord is my shepherd. He's my helper, amen. The Lord is my shepherd. By the way, looking at the Lord there, your Bible should be capital L, capital O, R, D, which signifies that it is Jehovah. And in the King James Bible, that is preserved throughout. When you see capital L, O, R, D, it always is translated Jehovah. A shepherd here is a Roi. So it could translate to be, the Lord is my shepherd, or or translated to be, the Lord is my shepherd, the Lord my shepherd, Jehovah Roi in Psalm 23 and verse number 1. By the way, I mentioned this as well. Down through the ages, whenever God did something or was something for Israel, they gave him a name. They gave him a name. These were some of the names that we looked at. Genesis 22, 14. You don't have to go there, but just listen to these because you probably can't get there. I've got my Bible marked. You don't read that. In Genesis 22, 14, he was Jehovah Jireh, the Lord will provide or see to it. And it reads as such. And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh, as it is said to this day in the mount of the Lord it shall be. What happened? Isaac should have been sacrificed, but instead of Isaac, God gave him a lion or a ram to sacrifice in his place. And so he called it Jehovah Jireh. The Lord will provide or see to it. In Exodus 15 and verse 26, it's Jehovah Rapha, or the Lord who heals. Exodus 15 and verse 26. And again, you might just want to write that down if you can't get there. Exodus 15, 26, it says this, and said, if thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God, and wilt do that which is right in his sight, and will give ear to his commandments and keep all these statutes, I will put none of these diseases upon thee, which I have brought upon the Egyptians. Of course, that's God speaking to Israel. For I am the Lord that healeth thee, or Jehovah Rapha, the Lord who heals. Come over a couple chapters to chapter 17. In chapter 17, it's Jehovah Nissi, or the Lord my banner, or the one that goes before me into battle. Exodus 17, and notice verse number 15. And Moses built an altar and called the name of it Jehovah Nissi. Jehovah Nissi. For he said, because the Lord has sworn that the Lord will have war with Amalek from generation to generation. So Jehovah Nissi, hear the Lord my banner. Leviticus 20 is Jehovah Mekadesh, or the Lord who sanctifies. Leviticus 20. And again, these were all designations that Israel gave to God when God did something for them. Leviticus 20, and notice verse number 8. And ye shall keep my statutes and do them. I am, notice this, the Lord which sanctify you, or set you apart from everybody else for my own use. Amen. Over in Judges, the book of Judges. So flip over several books there, and you'll find Judges chapter number 6 and verse number 24. And of course, in this passage, this is Gideon, 6:24. And notice what it says in verse 24. Then Gideon built an altar there unto the Lord and called it Jehovah Shalom. unto this day. It is yet an ultra of the Abiy. Abiy's rights. There you go. And because notice verse 23. The Lord said unto him, peace be unto thee, fear not, thou shalt not die. You saw God, you were supposed to die. And so he called it Jehovah Shalom, or in other words down there, the Lord is our peace. Come over to Jeremiah chapter 23. And these are all Jehovah titles that they gave to God. Jeremiah 23 in verse number 6. In Jeremiah 23, 6, Jehovah Sidkenu, or the Lord our righteousness. Notice verse number 6. In his days, Judah should be saved, and Israel should dwell safely. This is his name, whereby he shall be called the Lord our righteousness, or Jehovah Sidkenu. By the way, without the righteousness of the Lord Jesus Christ, we have no righteousness. Somebody say amen. All our righteousness, that's filthy rags, for the Lord, the Bible says. So these were designations that they gave. I'll give you one last one in Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 48. Ezekiel chapter 48, this is the last verse 35. And notice what it says. It was round about 18,000 measures. And the name of the city from that day shall be, notice this, the Lord is there, giving a description of what the times in the future would be like. The Lord is there. By the way, the Lord is with us even right now by his Spirit. Amen. But his physical presence would be with them in that day, in that time, in a future time and date. Amen. Just like it would be for you and I. Amen. And so these designations were given, and the Lord was to Israel what they needed him to be at that time, which lets me know that the Lord is going to be to you and I what we need as helper. Amen. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Makadash, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Sidkenu, Jehovah Shammah. The Lord will provide, the Lord who heals, the Lord by banner, the Lord who sanctifies, the Lord our peace, the Lord our righteousness, the Lord is there. Trivial question for you. Looking back on 2020, what name would you pick for God in your own life? What name would you pick? Helper, amen. Maybe provider. Maybe healer. Maybe teacher, comforter, counselor. Many have lost loved ones. Maybe a confider. Maybe a guider. What name would you say, God, this name best fits 2020 for me? You were my protector. You were my banner. You were my fighter. You were my soldier. You were my financial guider. You helped me stretch and go. You gave me what I need. What name would it be for you? Sure, everybody's got one. Somebody may have several. If you had to pick a name for our Lord, like Israel did with Jehovah Jireh, the Lord will provide, Jehovah Rapha, Lord who heals, Jehovah Nissi, Lord my banner. If you had to pick a name, what would that name be? Maybe defender, maybe guide. Folks, the fact of names is, we may have to come up with some new names in 2021. We don't know what's going to happen in 2021. We got an idea, but we don't know. Folks, when I set out last year to start preaching the Lord is and going through lists, and the Lord is my and going through lists, March brought on COVID. And I had to change direction. I had to preach a whole different type of messages. When we came back, I couldn't restart this series right away. Why? It came to my attention that we had not invested in God the way we should have before the COVID hit. And so when COVID hit, then he went bankrupt. And so we had to be reminded that we need to invest more in the Lord's Son, Jesus Christ. Invest more in the Lord's Word, which is not going to go away. Invest more in the Holy Spirit, who wants to have control over our lives and do some things. Invest more in what God would have us to do, because those prayers can't be taken away. Because we saw everything that we held dear can be taken away, including people we love. Now, we knew it as a reality, but we had always thought that it would be an accident, or someone's going to be chronically ill before. Not some pandemic that's going to sweep across the world. Oh, we're not just talking about America, I'm talking about the world. Now, in America, Arizona is front and center as far as infections. So in Psalm 23, go back there with me. Psalm 23, David said, you know, I don't need Jehovah Jireh, the Lord of the Vine. I don't need Jehovah Rapha, Lord of Heals. I don't need Jehovah Nisi, the Lord of my banner. I don't need Jehovah Nefesh, Lord of Sanctifies. I don't need Jehovah Shalom. I don't need the Lord is my peace. I don't need Jehovah Sikkim, the Lord of Righteous. I don't need Jehovah Shammah, the Lord is there. What I need is the Lord to be my shepherd. These are turbulent times in my life, and as a shepherd, boy, I need some guidance. I need someone who's going to do all of the others. Because if you think about it, the shepherd does provide like Jehovah Jireh. The shepherd does heal like Jehovah Rapha. The shepherd does protect like the Lord my banner. The shepherd does sanctify like Jehovah Mekadesh. The shepherd does provide my peace as Jehovah Shalom. The shepherd does provide my righteousness like Jehovah Sikkim. The shepherd is there like Jehovah Shalom. And so I need the shepherd. I need Jehovah Roi. He does all of the rest. And so I can boldly say, the Lord is my helper. And I will not fear what man do me. Because I don't know what 2020 one is going to bring in your life. I don't know what it's going to bring in my life. But ask yourself this question, what do you need right now? Guess what? The Lord is my helper. What will you need tomorrow? The Lord is my helper. What did you need last week? The Lord is my helper. What did you need yesterday? The Lord will still be helper. What will you need down the road next month? What will you need towards the end of the year? We really don't know. But it's good to know that God will be
whatever we need him to be while the Lord is.
He is. And me personally just happens to be my shepherd. And he provides everything that I need. Sheep don't know what they will need from moment to moment. They don't have a day planner. They don't have a calendar. Sheep don't have a schedule. They go where the shepherd tells them to go. They do what the shepherd tells them to do. And they take what the shepherd gives them because the shepherd knows what's best for them. And they do that every day.
When was the last time you saw a shepherd with a notebook calendar? When was the last time you saw him with a day planner? I wonder what we're doing next week. Are we going to a sheep basketball game? Are we going to a sheep volleyball game? What are we doing? Are we going to a sheep picnic? They don't see sheep. They live one day at a time. And folks, guess what? You and I are only promised one day at a time. And the Lord is our helper. We have seen that so vividly this last year. We only get one day at a time. We only get one shot at what we do that day. We have to live days. We don't get redos. And the Lord needs to guide us. And you want him to be your shepherd. Did we know COVID needs would exist before they did? And we really did. We looked at China and the rest of these people like, that is not us. And guess what? Within weeks, that was us. I looked at preachers and I thought, wow, I don't know any preachers. Didn't take long before I knew preachers. But Alfred King couldn't even be in the pulpit at New Testament Baptist Church the past 2 weeks. Chuck Hughes, when he works in our building, has been out for like 7 months. Because many folks he's exposed to. None of the 7 weeks. We're in Lancaster, or a chapel out of Lancaster, COVID. See, when you know people that have it, and we know people that died from it, it hits home. It hits home. God is up for the challenge because he knows what next pandemic is coming. He knows what next emergency is coming in your life. He knew what was going to happen with David's life. He knew what was going to happen with the Hebrews,
and that's why they said, God is my helper. I will not fear. What can I do?
God is up for the challenge in 2021, and will be what we need him to be for today, any place, in all situations, even future type things like COVID. My question is the Lord, can you say the Lord is my shepherd? Once, if you can't say it, make him your shepherd today. These are times that you don't want to navigate yourself. You want to have a provider. You want to have a protector. You want to have that shepherd that has gone this way before. If he's not your shepherd, you ask yourself, well, not. You say, well, Preacher, I made it last year okay. None of that was God's grace. That was his mercy. He allowed, because a lot of people didn't make it. And that was God's grace and mercy. So if he's not your shepherd, if you ain't alive, I plead with you, make him your shepherd. And then let him guide you day by day. It's okay to have plans. It's okay to have a day plan. I love the calendar. I love my calendar. I love planning my day. I love that. But God seems just to toss it up every day. Toss it up. We got a standing joke in our house now. We got a problem with our garage door. They got out three times to fix it. I told them, I said, third time's a charm. Guess what? They came out for the third time. Struck out. They got to come back in fourth time. Joshua had it down. He said, "Well, I'm really not going to get right on this third time. I'm going to have to miss it, son. It's there." And the guy took it down, and the previous guy had broken some parts in it. This bribe wouldn't work, and when he took it down, the parts fell out. I thought, I think you're not going to fix that today, right? He says, "You got that right." He said, "But we will replace everything. We won't charge you for it." And I'm thinking, Jehovah Shai, the Lord will see to it. The Lord will see to it. I don't want to get a free one, so I'll get a free one. Cost me 4 visits, so amen. Is the Lord your shepherd? If he is your shepherd, let him shepherd you today, tomorrow, and into the unknown 2021. Amen. Our heads are bowed, eyes are closed. Father, thank you so much for providing for me, providing for my family. Lord, I did not see a COVID coming last year at this time. January was well on its way, February was there, and I was looking to just go on with this subject matter of the Lord. And the Lord is, and the Lord is not. Lord, you intervened and allowed us to see how desperately we need you to be our shepherd, and how we need you to be the Lord my helper. So God, help us today to see what you want to do in our lives on a daily basis. For some, it may be getting saved today, and I pray for that. A person that has not received Christ, that they would understand that the end of the road without the shepherd, without the help of the Lord Jesus Christ, and their end road would be in a place called hell for eternal punishment. That's not the place you designated or designed for them. You love them and you provided for them, and you are their shepherd to get them shepherded into heaven. And so, Lord, help that man and his boy to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ that they might be saved in a place called hell. For those of us that are saved, Lord, help us to call you the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Because that involves everything else that is there. And Lord, because we don't know what to expect tomorrow, or next week, or next month, we need you to shepherd our lives so that God will direct us and lead us and show us what you want to do with us, and to help us like a sheep to follow and obey. Down by the green waters, the still waters, whatever it takes, watch over us. Pray for our loved ones. You raise them back up as well, Lord. But most of all, save souls, direct lives. Help us to make a decision to invest more in our relationship with the shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd.
Bless that interpretation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. Before the music starts, if you're listening online, I would encourage you to make the Lord Jesus Christ your Lord and your shepherd today. It's a very simple prayer. Lord, I know I've sinned, but I believe Jesus died for me. I believe he was buried for me and rose again forever for me. And ask him to be your shepherd. Ask him to be your Savior today and save you. He will do it. And then let him shepherd your life. If you hear this all the time, you've never done that, I encourage you to do the same thing. Ask him to shepherd your life. Why? You don't know 2021 is going to be. Bless God this invitation, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Jesus is going to play his invitation. God's going to be your heart, you move. You do what God asks you to do. My help comes from the Lord. The Lord, our help. He was everything that Israel needed him to be. And as everything that Israel needed, they lacked nothing. Together and help us be mindful to continue listening online and making sure we're reading our Bibles and staying prayed up for the challenges ahead. And we'll praise you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. Well, thank you again for your attendance today. Thank you for coming. Again, I don't know what's coming ahead, amen, but I am strapped down with the Lord and looking forward to it, amen. I trust you are as well. And as the sheep trusting the shepherd, let's just go ahead and live one day at a time, amen, and trust God for the victories. Amen. Pastor White's going to come and give you some parting words here. I'm sure encourage you about your duties. Amen. So let me say this as well before Pastor White comes. I appreciate all of your stewardship through 2020, amen, and appreciate your faithfulness. Our lights are on, salaries are paid, and everything happens here because of the time and offerings of God's people. And from the bottom of my heart, Mr. Elson's heart, we thank you, and Pastor Light, our faithful treasure. This is what Tamara doing the books, along with Mr. Dawson. We appreciate all your faithfulness and helping us out. Appreciate you.
Well, amen. It is good to be in the house of the Lord this morning. And it's amazing to me that think about 2020, how it went by. And I just praise the Lord that each day that went by last year, he was what I needed every day. And he'll be the same this coming year. Thank you, preacher, for the reminder. And again, as he's already mentioned, I hope and pray that you continue to be faithful in your stewardship and giving. We love to see the Lord blessing your life financially, and he will, because you'll be faithful to him, he'll be faithful to you. And if you haven't gotten your statements, you'll soon get those that are listening online in the mail. If you're not here today, hope to get those out to you in the mail this week. And some have already gone out. If you're here this morning, I believe I have most of you that are here that statements for you. And we're looking forward to God blessing us financially again this year as a church and you as givers. Amen. And again, thank you for being here this morning, listening online, those being here in the church services as well. To my right, you out here, and out to my left, the back and out. It would be greatly appreciated from you as we continue to practice. As we always have here, try to make sure we're doing the things to keep ourselves safe and in harm's way of the COVID. But again, thank you again for being here this morning. Let's pray and ask God's blessings as we depart and go our way for the day. And pray you have a good afternoon and tune in online tonight. Look forward to meeting our young people again today as well. So we just praise the Lord for that privilege as well. Thank you again, Father, for just being such a wonderful and gracious God. Thank you for the plentifulness that you provide in everything that you are to us each and every day, Lord. You know the needs that we have in our lives, and you have not failed us in no way, no form, or fashion. And we're just so thankful and gracious to you for being such a merciful God. We love you and praise you. Thank you for what you do. Pray that you be with us this coming day and throughout this year, Lord, provide and meet every need that we have, that we can truly say it has been good to be in the house of the Lord this morning to hear such an encouraging message from the Word of God. We thank you for the messenger and his family and the faithfulness that they've been to this church throughout the years and the days to come. We pray your blessings upon those that are listening online as well, that they will sense your presence in their lives, and those that have come this morning to be here in this presence and under the sound of my voice. I pray you bless them as we go out here this morning. Again, we love you and praise you. Thank you for all that you do. And for what you're going to do, we ask these things now in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. Amen.